All right, welcome back, everyone. So we are moving out. We just took the... We killed the 777 pirates for the second time for Ravinia. Now we're gonna go to the fun adventure for our first time ever in our BDO career. We're gonna go kill a Candidum. Mostly because we want the Moonscale plywood. But what do these Aquila coins actually do? Alrighty. So, one of two things is probably going to happen today. We kill Candidum, get our quest done, easy. Or the Candidum sinks our boat and we get destroyed. So we got some extra origin of wind. I'll use these if I really need to, but I would like to. If I didn't have to, I won't, but I would love to. But yep, it's the first time going to the Candidum area. My guildie said I should be fine. I told them I had an improved frigate with +6 gear, and they're like, yeah, you'll be fine. So, I hope it works. But yeah, they said it's just like, it's no harder than like a Hecaru or a Nine Shark. It's just they're a little bit tankier. So we have to go past Vel again. Go past Vel and then up. How much time do we have left on our... Dude, I don't even know how much time we have on our comp. Oh, 44 minutes. I was like, wait. I'm so glad they gave these for the pearl thingies today. It's like 11 pearls for that, so super worth, especially for me. Kind of excited and kind of nervous at the same time. The only actual sea monsters I've done are Hecaru, One Nine Shark, and Ocean Stalkers. Mostly, yeah. If this saves me 1,600 C coins, so I don't have to do it. Dear God, I am not going to do that. They should add more types of PvE out here. Because they added the Sea of Silence, which is to curse pirate ships, but like you really don't see any out there. You have to like just sit there and hope something pops up. Compared to like Ocean Stalkers and Hecarus, where they're just kind of like roaming. Alrighty, are we close to Ville? Kinda. We should get these. Sarka's up. Oh, Jesus. God, dude, I just like looked at that at the right time. Holy. Good. Don't mind me. Wrong button. You know what's scary? Well, it's almost daytime right now, but in the middle of the night when it's almost pitch black, try diving underwater out in the middle of the ocean. You actually see, like, nothing, and it's kind of scary. Oh, God, it's so bright, dude. Why? Can't even see the sun, let's not stare at it. God, the waves are stupid strong. Well, it's kind of scary. What was that red? Okay, you see that, like, stuff? What is that? Oh, nice. Not nighttime. Imagine fighting an empowered sea monster. Let's just drive right into that twister real quick. You know how they have, like, those desert portals that take you to Achman in history? Imagine if they had something that takes you down into the ocean. The weather just changes so instantly. Into Candidum zone soon. Is that it? No, that's not it. What is that? That might be it. Doesn't look familiar. Yeah, that's it. Wait, Candidums are sharks? Okay. Well, it's the first one I'm ever fighting in my entire BDO career, so let's hope for the best. Yeah, but I just heard they're tanky, but they're not, like, hard, dude. Dude, do you ever just, like, appear? That does a little bit of damage. Dude, they just, like, run away from you. Barely hit them. I your boat is sailing backwards like that, how do you... I legit don't understand how the cannons work in this game. It's like, I feel like I'm hitting them, but then underwater damage makes zero difference. Tanky things, dear God. It's like these things don't really want to attack you, but they just run away. What are those things? Its health bar is not moving. Still in the yellow zone. To orange. So it goes from yellow, orange, dark orange, red. Frickin' thing, just stop swimming away, just attack my boat, it's fine. What is this NPC behavior? Because it's underwater for so long, I can't even tell what it is. Is it like a shark or is it a whale shark? Why are you swimming away? It's coming back, boys, let's go! Pirate ship too. Hello? Come back. Because each cannon reload takes so long, I just want to line it up and make sure I can actually hit it. That's why I'm trying to like be careful with my shots. Ugh. Okay, we got this. Thank you. people do this for fun? I can't, dude. Like, if this was more aggressive, where it tried to attack your boat constantly, that would be so much nicer. But instead, it just wants to swim away. What kind of sea monster are you? Oh, dark orange! We're like halfway, I think, or 75%. I don't even know why I was worried about this. It went underwater last second, I missed. I'm gonna need someone to explain to me when sea monster hunting gets fun. Sailing the ocean's fun. Sea monster hunting, not so much. All you get is like one shell out of it too for this Candidum. Please! Just stand there for a second. I think I hit it a few times. That's cool. Where are you going? Don't you just want to attack the boat that's shooting cannons at you? Why are you running? Oh, it's red health. Dude, what did we actually get? We got one shell. All right, now we gotta go back to the island. We got one shell, 39 of these. We got knowledge, so that's pretty good. I'll just hold on to him. It's not like it's a big deal. Trace of wave. You know what I never want to do? Fight a Candidum again. They really need to, like, change the sea monster behavior. Just like, run away. Oh, we're gonna be skilled 8 today. Nice. Beginner 4 bartering Omega lol. Dude, I still actually have no idea. Like, well, actually, skilled 4 is on the, I don't know, that's high, but I've seen people like professional bartering. How fast does your boat have to be to, like, do that? Oh, 20 more minutes. Dang, that people are still going for Logia. That's cool. When it comes to Logia gathering gear, I honestly think you should probably, I don't know if like going to Tet is worth it. Like, stay try if you're at Logia gear until you can actually move up to Monos. I just don't think like wasting money on Tet Logia is worth it. Got it. Yay. Oh my god, we saved 1600 coins by not having to do that. Here, let me repair my... But yeah, so we got 10 of these. We're done with the cobalt ingots now. We got a lot of these in our storage. We can get this tomorrow. It's not a big deal. We're about halfway for the all of these. I can make these. It's not a problem. Ooh, uh-oh. Elder tree sap. I need like 5,000 of them, aren't I? White cedar sap. I'm pretty sure I actually have that one. Wait a second. This one look like I swear I have that one somewhere. Must have sold it. Oh wait, is that Elder? Oh my god, dude. Dude, we have it. I'm so glad I didn't sell it. Yay. I need a lot of that. But for real though, like, I swear I have white cedar sap somewhere. Where would it be? I don't know, I could have sworn it was... Maybe I don't have it. I have white, the Elder Tree sap, which is amazing. Let me see. So we got this done. We can get this soon. This is just expensive. 600 mil, but we're gonna light 600 mil on fire anyway doing this, so we'll get that. Old tree bark. I have all the materials for that. Zinc ingots. I have a lot. I have this at plus 10. Yeah, we're just gonna need a lot of verdant stones. Oh, I forgot. That's not our boat. All right, we're gonna go back to the Crow's Nest, turn this in for day 5. Oh. I'm so glad we got this. I really just wish the Verdant Stones weren't so tedious to get. So these things, you turn in level 1 trade goods for them. And you get the Verdant Blackstones. And you need 55 for one piece of gear to get to plus 10. And I need about 115 more, or 115 total to be done. And it's about another 90 to go. Dear God. So it's like every 4 hours on refresh, I have to get like 6 level 1 gears or level 1 things done. $2 tree sap is so expensive. What a relief, dude. Just getting this done. Yeah, the hardest part is going to be getting those Verdant Stones. Everything else would be straightforward. How many more can we get? So I should probably get all of them per barter cycle. Reset. 4 hours. Okay. That's the island. All right, let's see what we're at. Sailing, 90%, skilled 7. We'll probably be at like either a low skilled 9 or high skilled 8 after we turn it in. Actually, no, 60,000 XP is probably, we're gonna be at like, I think we'll be at skilled 8, 50%. Go whiffed. When did that CTG go out? Hour ago. All right, predictions. Skilled 8, 50%. We got it. Oh, so close. Anyway, what does she sell again? That is so expensive, dude. Oh my. We got this done today. That was the big highlight. I was about to spend 1600 coins for them too, but turns out there's a quest that gives them. Abyssal gem. I don't know what half of these things do. Exchange level 4 sea goods times 1 for 10. Oh, this must be like high tier. Okay. So yeah, we got three of these two. Yeah, we need a lot of these, another 100 or so. But yeah, with that said, I think we're done for today. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you guys tomorrow. We'll do day 6. and then day 7, and then I don't know what else, but we'll make our video, like, documenting everything up until we get our Gallius, so you guys can do it too. But yeah, I think I'm out for today. Thanks so much for watching. It's Christmas Dark Night. I'll see you guys later.